boom, and like, oof.
I love it.
Hayao Miyazaki-esque. So personal and so close to her heart. Okay, this is getting really deep. Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Alina Naza, and today, it finally happened. Billie Eilish dropped a new single. So I'm gonna listen to it, review it, react to it. This is the first time I'm gonna listen to it. I haven't heard it yet. And I'm very excited. And if we manage to manifest a new single by Billie Eilish, we can do anything in this world. It's called My Future. And that already makes me think that it's gonna be very, you know, usual Billie, sad and wistful. Let's find out. I'm already sad.
I can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice I'm not here. I'm just a mirror. Can't you?
I love that it's animated.
Me? I'm not coming.
It's giving me like a Hayao Miyazaki vibe.
Supposedly I'm lonely. No, I'm supposedly unhappy without someone.
I like it.
I know better than to drive you home. Love with my future, and you don't know.
I love it. I love how the animation changed with her. Oh, okay. Oh, all right. Okay, I like this. I like this a lot. You know why? Because this is like showing the trajectory after Everything I Wanted, for sure. Because in Everything I Wanted, she was so sad. She was so low. She was facing the kind of negatives to achieving her dreams and all that. This is like Billie had time to just chill in quarantine, do some meditation, do some self-work. It's quite positive. Like, it starts gloomy and doomy, and her tone of voice is always a bit like somber, but I like it. It has like a positive outlook towards the end. And honestly, like, I feel that right now so much as well. I think it's very relatable for everybody in your early to mid-20s. Where you're still sort of looking for yourself and stuff, and you just gotta fall in love with your future and try to become that person and put that as a priority above everyone and everything else. Okay, this is getting really deep. July 30th. Yeah, this song came out on Finneas' birthday. And another thing I wanted to say, actually, you know when the beat drops and it goes from being somber to a bit more optimistic, having a bit more movement?
Supposedly I'm lonely.
And that's like halfway into the song, full on. The song is like 4 minutes, this is 2 minutes in. Yeah, so when the beat drops, that just made me think of like more of Finneas's work. Because the stuff that he does with Billie is usually very bass. Oh, sorry. Earthquake. Her music is usually very bass heavy and just like deep and multi-layered and boom and like oof.
Smack the lip, whoop, drop down, snap, ah!
You know, like a big impact, bad guy. Most of her songs from her last album. It's more of a Finneas sound, because if you listen to his music, it's brighter. The beats are a bit lighter, the song is a bit lighter generally. It's not as like, oof, bass heavy. And it's very interesting because I feel like I've heard the song before, even though it's the first time listening to it, which I think is a marker of a great song. My brain is responding to it really well. Unless they're secretly plagiarizing someone and I'm completely unaware. First of all, it's a pandemic now, so it's a great idea. Hayao Miyazaki-esque. He's basically the Walt Disney of Japan. So Spirited Away, Howl's Moving Castle, awesome animations like that. And it's always like dreamy and nostalgic and just magical. Especially the little close-ups on like the little trees and the little raindrops. I love how there was a progression to it, that everything started dark and gloomy, but ended up being bright and positive right after the rain. Oh, and Jack and the Beanstalk. The little froggy dude. What I got from this is that in this song, in my future, she walks away from a relationship and decides to put herself first, which is good because she's young and she shouldn't chain herself down. Generally, I feel like this is a song about learning how to be alone, kind of concentrating on yourself over anyone else. It's about personal growth. Clearly, this quarantine has done her some good. I hope it's done a number of us some good. It's definitely an experience I had to go through as well. Yeah, I didn't really know what to expect, honestly, because a lot of her songs so far have been a lot about, like, taking on particular roles. They have a story, right? They have a story and they pursue it. With Bellyache, it was about a young kid killing her friends and driving them in the car. And Bad Guy is about being, like, you know, whatever, the macho guy, and then you're, like, showing off trying to be the bad girl. I'm pleasantly surprised that it's so personal and so close to her heart and so vulnerable. If I had to pick a favorite lyric so far, it's I'm in love with my future and I can't wait to meet her. Ah, I feel the same way, Billie. Oh my god, how do you know me so well? Ah. So good. Talent. Just talent, guys. Just pure talent. I like that there's a positive message at the end. We really need this right now, and it's good that Billie's putting it out there and people are listening to it. Exactly what everyone needs to hear right now. Taking this time to like introspect and look into what you want from this life, guys. Getting deep again. That was my review and reaction. I hope you guys enjoyed this little episode. If you did, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Let me know what you thought of the song in the comment section below. Did you like the animation, or would you have preferred like a proper video clip? Personally, really liked it, and I think it's very fitting, but I don't know. Kind of miss Billie's face as well. It would be nice to see her. Thanks for watching. This is Alina Naza, and I will see you guys next time. Ciao.